The bringers of the dawn are those who carry the rays of the sun and bring light and knowledge. They have an ancient organization, an ancient society, an ancient spiritual bonding that keeps them doing certain work within a certain star system. The members of this elite organization come to Earth at different times to do their work. This occurs when a cycle has been set and events are perfect for them to allow the energy from the high cosmos and the energy from Earth to merge within their own beings. The energies from the cosmos are always coming to Earth, and the energies from Earth are always lifting up towards the cosmos. Humanity creates the sacred bridge between Earth and sky, which some have called the Rainbow Bridge. The bringers of the dawn allow these energies to merge so that the dawn, or the light, is awakened within them. They then bring that dawn to civilizations. This is who you are. This is what you are doing. So are multitudes of others. You are the bringers of the dawn. You, the bringers of the dawn, also known as the family of light, agreed to go through the process of mutation to evolve yourselves into higher beings by intention and conscious agreement. Members of the bringers of the dawn or family of light work in teams. You don't go into systems alone. You need each other to do this work because you cannot hold the frequency by yourself. By going in as teams, you increase the odds of successfully carrying out the plan. You are like rays and light spirals of the central sun that are very intelligent, and you are guided by a great intelligence inside the central sun. The members of the family of light are much more than human. Characteristically, you are supreme achievers in the multidimensional realm. One applies for a position in the multidimensional realm as a member of the family of light. If you were to have a business card printed up for yourselves when you are in full memory of your identity, it would say something like, Renegade Member of Family of Light, Systems Buster, available for altering systems of consciousness within the free will universe, on call. You are renegades of light, and you decide to come back and stage another raid of consciousness, millions of you at this time, because you knew in working with Prime Creator's energy that there was a high probability that everyone would achieve a great richness of consciousness. As you begin to pull this light into your bodies and onto the planet, many people who like drama may be affected. They may be pierced by light and have a reaction, because the more light you bring, the faster it will spread. Light is definitely growing on the planet as you remember that you are the native species working closely with the original planners here to take back your world from the raiders. In order to survive in the times that are coming, it is imperative to move into the idea of thought manifestation or superconsciousness. There are those who are very aware that this movement of consciousness could begin to sweep the planet, and they are banking on it not occurring. It has already occurred. We have come back into your past to assure you of this. Thought comes first. Experience is always secondary. It is never the other way around, that you have the experience and then you base the thought around it. Always your experience is a direct reflection of what you are thinking. Clarity and recognition of your own power are the bottom line. Your thoughts form your world all of the time. Because you are bombarded with so many frequency control vibrations that attempt to keep you from being clear, you fluctuate. You must, as a species, make it your intention to stay very clear, to stay centered, and always to bring yourself into the moment. Stop living in the future or living in the past, and always live in your now. Say to yourself, What do I want? I want to accelerate my personal evolution. I want spirit to assist me in a greater capacity. I want my body to regenerate itself. I want to emanate health. I am willing to give up difficulty so that I can be a living example of what humanity can be. It is this line of thinking, this commanding from your being and calling out what you want with clarity, that brings you everything in acceleration. Do not be afraid of what you create. Trust what you create. Trust that there is always something in it for you. Do not sweep your dramas under the rug as if they are old, dirty, horrible things and you never wish to see them again. Get finished with these dramas. Stop cycling in them and being lost in them. However, understand that the drama you have had with your mother, your brother, your sister, your lover, is something you may use 20 years later to come to a whole new realization. So let these life dramas be like a file for you. Finish them up, resolve them as best you can, create peace, accept your part in them, and then let them cycle back through your consciousness to teach you something. Those who are involved in dramas in which it looks like someone is a victim are usually so out of touch with their feelings that they do not connect how they feel with what they are thinking. Victims find victims. Victors find victors. You are a result of your thoughts. If there is nothing else you learn on this planet, you will learn that this is the rule in this reality and of many other realities. Your words are either empowering or disempowering. We want you to have the courage to live your light, so we want to emphasize to you and convince you in whatever way possible that your thoughts formulate your world. Eliminate the words should and trying from your vocabulary. Should implies that you are operating under someone else's sovereignty. We would like to remind you that you are sovereign unto yourself. If someone is trying to put out a newsletter or trying to change their patterns, they can try for the rest of their life. Trying is not doing. Whenever you use the word trying, you will not accomplish anything because trying is an excuse. I tried to do it. I tried. I tried. In your own life, use the words, I am creating. I am doing. I am manifesting, I am intending, and I am bringing about. Forget I am trying. State of mind is the name of the game here. We cannot emphasize that to you enough. How you feel about reality and how you program reality is how you are going to respond to it or how it is going to present itself to you. Remember, when you learn the rules of the game, that you are a result of thought, and that this is a law within your universe, all you need do is think of how you want to be, and so you shall be. Once you figure this out, you can design your body, you can design your age, you can fix everything about yourself, because you will be self-motivated, self-empowered, and self-generated. It is time for all of you to redefine your own identities in a much greater sense. Events are transpiring in the cosmos that you and even many of your political leaders have no idea of. You must stop this foolishness about your definitions of gods, thinking that there are beings who come from the skies to this planet with special talents and abilities and that they are all spiritually connected. You are going to discover, as a species, some very disturbing ideas over the next number of years. We are preparing you by decree of the Family of Light so that you can understand and be informed about your own options. Reach out with your feeling center and feel the confusion that is spreading around this world about what is going on. This planet has operated on a very low frequency, a frequency based on survival, and a frequency based on disempowerment. Your identity has been based on what you could gather outside of yourself. The 12 helixes will render irrelevant everything that has represented and surrounded the two helixes. All of the money saved and property owned, all of the security based on the first two helixes that provides you with identity, is completely irrelevant to the evolution of the planet. This planet is in desperate need of committed entities who are in search of the exalted self. The continuity we have been speaking of, that it will behoove you to bring into your lives, involves knowing from moment to moment inside your beings that you are committed to discovering this exaltation. This exaltation can be translated in words as a frequency, or a wave of feeling, or vibration. You all understand vibration in terms of light and sound. Vibrations are ongoing. They carry and transmit forms of intelligence. When you look to yourself and do not forget that you are on this path, and you continuously remind yourself that you are pulling light into your body and are seeking to raise the frequency of your physical being, defy the laws of humanity, and alter the frequency of the planet, you are producing a kind of continuity that can do more than all the books and tapes in the world. Wherever you are, use the pillar of light. We recommend that each of you visualize a pillar of light coming in through the top of your head, opening your crown, and filling your body with light. Picture this cosmic pillar of light coming from the higher cosmos, filling you, and then coming out your solar plexus and making a ball of light around your body so that you exist within a glowing etheric egg. When you love yourself and Earth, and you know that you are here to redefine, redesign, and break the boundaries of humanity, you broadcast this. You live your life committed to this. If you ask us how much time you need to devote to this, we will say, it is very simple, all of your time. You each came to this planet to do a task, and that task is at hand. It is now. The decade of change is upon you, and as you integrate and realize what this change means, it will alter each and every one of your lives. The change means giving up many things, coming apart from many things, and coming together with other things, because you will trust. What does it mean to trust? It means to have such inner knowing that your thoughts create your world, to simply be quite certain, with divine nonchalance and inner knowing, that if you think of something, it is. It is this theme over and over again that we are attempting to present to you in every capacity and every means of expression, so that one of these days you will get it. Once you get it and begin to live it, you will begin to change your lives. You have purpose because all aspects of consciousness are connected to one another. None exist outside the system. They are all parts of the whole. The essence of the vehicle you occupy and the energy you generate are part of the developmental sequence that you can say has a purpose for your personal search in life. We speak to you as if you are not human, because to us, you are not. To us, you are members of the family of light, and we know your multidimensional selves. We speak to you about dealing with humans because it is your assignment to integrate with them, soothe them, and awaken a spark of light within them so that they are not all destroyed, and so that this place can house a new species and a new realm of activity. There is an order that you operate within that part of yourself cannot see. Sometimes when part of yourself is operating without vision or seeing, events occur to get you back on track. Be aware that in this new chaos of consciousness and confusion and shifting of uncertainty, there is a divine order. What can we say to convince you to take all of the boundaries down, to stop limiting what you believe can be yours? If there is anything we wish to achieve, it is to have each of you boundless and free, knowing that every thought you entertain somehow determines your experience. If we could get you to live 100% of the time according to what you want, we would feel that this has been a most successful year. We are going to ask each of you to make that commitment and to live a cleaner and more impeccable life. We ask you to accept responsibility in areas that you have not even thought of accepting responsibility. We want you each to act as if you know what's going on. Act as if you are divinely guided in every choice you make, and begin to believe that you are always at the right place at the right time. Say to yourself, I am in divine guidance. I am always at the right place at the right time. Everything I do is orchestrated for my higher growth, for my higher consciousness, and my higher evolution. Be living keepers of frequency. When light is brought into your body, it fires your light-encoded filaments and helps rebundle the DNA, creating a frequency change. Frequency is what you know. Frequency is your identity. When your own life rises to a position where you do not even recognize it as your life, you allow the energy of the non-physical realms to use you as a conduit, to merge the dimensions and liberate consciousness into a new way of perceiving. Even though there is death and destruction coming to your world, remember that death and destruction come in the autumn every year on this planet. The flowers and leaves on the trees are killed by the frost. Things wither and die. Perhaps someone who lives where it is always summer would be very disturbed when they saw autumn for the first time. They would think, goodness, the world is being destroyed here. All the beauty is being taken away. Understand that this is what is going on with Earth. It is a season when some things will die so that many new things can be born. It is all part of the divine plan. There is a plan to catapult and send energy into new experience. At this time, Earth and a number of other systems where you simultaneously exist are instrumental in the reemergence of emotion with the purpose of comprehending all identities compacted into one. The universes are discovering what they can do by coming together and interworking, just as you are discovering what you can become. There is no preconceived idea of what will happen. This is new territory. Emotion is the key to all of this. As human beings, you need emotion to connect you with your spiritual self. Emotion is essential to understanding spirituality because emotion generates feeling. The mental body and physical body are very linked, as are the emotional body and spiritual body. The spiritual body is, of course, the body that exists beyond physical limitation. You need emotions to comprehend the non-physical, which is why emotions have been so controlled upon this planet. Most human beings are afraid of their emotional or feeling center. They are afraid to feel. Trust your feelings no matter what they are. When you are not afraid of feeling and you move past judgment and allow yourself to feel all the ways you feel, you will have a tremendous breakthrough, because you will be able to ride feeling into other realities. Some of you are afraid to feel and participate in this reality, let alone ride into other realities, because you do not trust your feelings. If you wish to have an acceleration, dive into something that brings up feeling. Stop skirting the issue so that you can think you are in control. Dive in the middle of it, and then see if you are in control. You must learn to love your emotions. As long as you describe something as difficult, you are making it difficult. You are resisting and judging the changes coming about. You are feeling that you do not know what is going on and you wish to be in control. You must be very selective about what you decide to control or not control. You, as members of the family of light, are having an awakening. You need your emotions. You must become friends with your emotions because through feelings you can climb the ladder to the multidimensional self and the 12 chakra system and explore what you discover. Through feelings you can tell if something is going on or not. The logical mind will disinvolve itself when something is going on if the body is not plugged into feeling. Feeling registers frequency change. Logical mind does not register frequency change. Feeling is what connects you to your humanity. Feeling is what connects you to your emotions. Emotions connect you in this realm of existence to your spiritual body. What we are saying is that your emotions or feelings are the key to being alive in this reality. If you are feeling pain within your emotional body, ask yourself why you believe the pain is there, what purpose the pain serves, and why you are choosing to create pain through your emotions. Why is it not your choice to create joy? All is choice. We need to remind you of this. This beautiful earth is a treasure so profound and so magnanimous that it draws those from far in space to come cherish the beauty that is here. We want you to feel that beauty inside yourselves and let it pulsate within your own beings. As you allow this beauty to come into you, it will move you profoundly, and you will begin as a species to command that the beautification of Earth become the first priority for all. We want to seed this idea into you so that you awaken to your responsibility to Earth. We have awakened within you the responsibility to yourselves, and you are on the road to becoming the best that you can be. We congratulate you. Now, what are you going to do for Earth, and how are you going to do it? Communicate with Earth, listen to it, and let this beautiful planet teach you how to live in harmony. Earth is a sentient being or collection of beings. The sentient beings that make up Earth come into this collective of consciousness out of love for the unity of this consciousness and desire to experience being a home for consciousness. Earth understands that in order to be a good mother to its children, it must let the children learn their own lessons. Your lessons are, of course, the lessons of responsibility. If you want something, there are certain ramifications and things you must do and responsibilities you must take on to accomplish your goal. Earth is teaching human beings responsibility by allowing you to create disruption upon its surface and into its interior. Earth is striving for its integrity. The planet feels at this time deprived of its integrity, dishonored and unloved. Earth loves you and gives you a place to operate. It is a living organism. Earth is about to reestablish its integrity and let you understand the importance of loving yourself by loving Earth. Love yourself and love Earth because they are one and the same. Earth is more resilient than you would imagine. It is here to feed you and sustain you. The animals are also here to work in cooperation with you. If everything is done with love, it has the force of the Creator behind it. Done with love, there would be no hurt and no harm. If you need a guide to make decisions about your behavior, ask yourself, am I operating with my highest integrity? Am I operating with love? Is love my intention for Earth, the animals, all the people I encounter, and all the things I do? When enough people create their own reality, consciously create it, you will create a new planet. There will literally be a splitting of worlds. This splitting will more than likely not occur for more than 20 years.